we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section complex analysis, and the problem is based on the concept of the analyticity of a function at the point at infinity. This problem has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020, and it is from the section B. The problem is: a function f from the complex plane C to the complex plane C is said to be analytic at infinity if the function g defined by g of w is equal to f of 1 by w is analytic at 0, the origin, with an appropriate value given for g of 0. Then which of the following statements is true? We are given four options. Option 1, any non-constant polynomial is analytic at infinity. Option 2, if f is analytic at infinity, then f is bounded. Option 3, for any z naught in C, the function f of z is equal to e power 1 by z minus z naught is analytic at infinity. Option 4, any entire function can be extended to an analytic function at infinity. Now, we are given the definition of the analyticity at infinity. We have a function f from C to C, and f is said to be analytic at infinity if the function g defined by g of w is equal to f of 1 by w is analytic at 0 with an appropriate value given to g of 0. Now we start discussing the given problem. Let's take the statement that is given in option 1. Any non-constant polynomial is analytic at infinity. And we give a counterexample. Let fz be a non-constant polynomial of degree 1, say az plus b. We have taken a function f of z is a non-constant polynomial of degree 1. Let us say that as f of z is equal to az plus b. Then g of z is equal to f of 1 by w. That will be equal to a times, in the place of z we write 1 by w plus b. Take the LCM. Bw plus a by w has a pole at w is equal to 0 of order 1. That is, g of w is not analytic at 0. Therefore, f of z is equal to az plus b, a non-constant polynomial of degree 1, is not analytic at infinity. So this is the counterexample. But this example can be extended to any polynomial of degree n also. If you take g f of z is a non-constant polynomial of degree n, then g of w is equal to f of 1 by w will have a pole at w is equal to 0 of order n. And therefore, our option 1 is not true. We continue. We go for the option 2. In option 2, it is given, if f is analytic at infinity, at the point at infinity, then f is bounded. We again give you a counterexample. Let f of z is equal to 1 by z. It's very clear. F of z is not bounded. And f of z is analytic at the point at infinity because g of w is equal to f of 1 by w is equal to w, which is analytic at w is equal to 0. So So that means f of z is equal to 1 by z is analytic at infinity, but it is not bounded. So your statement, if f is analytic at infinity, then f is bounded, is not true. Therefore, the option 2 is not true. We continue for the third option. The statement that is given in the third option is, for any z naught in C, the function f of z is equal to e power 1 by z minus z naught is analytic at infinity. So we have the function f of z, and that is equal to e power 1 by z minus z naught, where z naught is any point in C. Now write down g of w, that is equal to f of 1 by w, and wherever there is a z, you write 1 by w, and on simplification that will be e power w by 1 minus w z naught. Now we observe that w by 1 minus w z naught is analytic at w is equal to 0, and we see that g is an exponential function, therefore is an entire function. So composing these two things, we'll get g of w is analytic at w is equal to 0. Therefore, your function f of z is equal to e power 1 by z minus z naught, where z naught is any element in C, is analytic at infinity. Thus, the option 3 is true. We go for the last option, that is the fourth option. Any entire function can be extended to an analytic function at infinity. Let fz be an entire function, and suppose that it can be extended to an analytic function at infinity. This means what? F of z is analytic in the extended complex plane. In the extended complex plane. And this implies f of z is constant. Why? We recall this theorem. Every function analytic in the extended plane, extended complex plane, is a constant. So fz is analytic in the extended complex plane. Therefore, fz will become constant because of this result. And this is this you can see as a corollary to Lively's theorem. We give a counterexample to option 4 to strengthen our argument. Let fz is equal to z. It is a non-constant entire function. Well, assume that it can be extended to an analytic function at infinity. That means f of z is equal to z is analytic at infinity. That means g of w is equal to f of 1 by w is equal to 1 by w is analytic at 0, which is not true. Why? Because 1 by w is not analytic at 0. So your assumption that it can be extended to an analytic function at infinity is not true. Therefore, it cannot be extended to an analytic function at infinity. Therefore, the option 4 is not true. So in all the four options, only option 3 is true. So therefore, our answer is the option 3 is true. So that is a very simple and straightforward question based on the definition of the analyticity of a given function at the point at infinity. I hope that you have understood the solution of this problem and go on working out some more problems on these lines. I wish you all the best. Thank you.